And have patience. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with those who observe patience. The context of this is very profound. The Sahaba are outnumbered. They number just above 300. And the opposing army is much stronger, well equipped, larger in number, larger in forces. And when they're meeting, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds the Muslims, وَلَا تَنَازَعُوا. You do not have the liability, you do not have the liberty, you do not have the opportunity to fight among one another. Why not? فَتَذْهَبَ رِيحُكُمْ. That your strength will go away. Have patience. And this is something which is pronounced throughout the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That when some of the Aws would say, we are from Aws, and the people of Khazraj would sometimes say, we are from Khazraj, Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam would say, أَدَعْوَ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ وَأَنَا بَيْنَ رَحْمَانِيكُمْ. That how dare you make chants of ignorance when I'm still among you. And it's fascinating because on the opposite end, وَإِذْ زَيَّنَ لَهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ أَعْمَالَهُمْ وَقَالَ لَا غَالِبَ لَكُمْ الْيَوْمِ. Shaytan, he beautifies for the opposing army whatever it is that they're doing. Meaning the opposing army, the mushrikun. That don't worry, لَا غَالِبَ لَكُمْ الْيَوْمِ. Nobody's going to overpower you today. So continue fighting. And when they lose, إِنِّي بَرِيءٌ مِنْكَ. إِنِّي أَرَى مَا لَا تَرَوْنَ. That I have nothing to do with you. But what's the lesson that we learned from this? That when we need unity the most, we cannot afford to fight and bicker with one another. Especially claims to unnecessary jahili terms. That I'm from a particular place. I'm from a particular tribe. I am better than you. I know more than you. My skin color makes me more superior than you. Statements like this is what leads to the downfall of a nation. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's protection from such statements. Because as Muslims, what binds us and unifies us is tawheed. Kalimat la ilaha illallah. No racial affiliation makes us stronger than our iman, regardless of where my mom or my dad is from. Regardless of where I was born. Regardless of the language that I speak. Because if we start fighting with one another on such arbitrary grounds that I'm from somewhere, or you're not from somewhere, or my skin tone is something, your skin tone is not this, we may not verbalize it, but it's embedded within us. At times, we feel that we're better than other people. And I address this to myself. Who am I to say I'm better than someone else? هَلْ شَفَقْتَ قَلْبَ? Did I open someone's chest and see what's inside of their hearts? But we do not have the ability at this point. We cannot afford to fight with one another. وَلَا تَنَازَعُوا فَتَفْشَلُوا وَتَذْهَبَ رِيحُكُمْ. Because if we fight right now, there's a whole horde of people out there, outside of our sanctuary, who are willing to galvanize, who are willing to seize this opportunity and bring us down. So the first lesson we learn is the necessity of unity. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Al-mu'minu lil-mu'mini kal-bunyan yashuddu ba'duhu ba'da. In a sahih hadith, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, the example of one believer and another believer is what? They are bricks. Each brick supports the other brick until they become an impenetrable fortress. That means you and I, brothers and sisters, together we're one community. We define strength. We define community. And we ask Allah to strengthen our bonds and never allow unnecessary bickering and very arbitrary grounds to divide us. The second topic Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses, and I want to speak about this. Allah says, إِنَّمَا يَعْمُرُ مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَأَقَامَ الصَّلَاةَ وَآتَ الزَّكَاةَ وَلَمْ يَخْشَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ فَعَسَىٰ أُولَٰئِكَ أَنْ يَكُونُ مِنَ الْمُهْتَدِينَ. That alhamdulillah, we are all present in the masjid today praying salah with jama'ah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, which group of people populate the masjid? Those people who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who pray the salah, who give the zakah, and they fear none but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The fact that we're congregated here, inshaAllah, in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is a testimony to this for us in Yawm al-Qiyamah, inshaAllah. And we should highly emphasize populating the masjid. It's very important. What does it mean that I am a Muslim when I do not frequent the masjid as I ought to? What does it mean that I build a Muslim community when I do not populate the masjid? So Allah says, who populates the masjid? Those who have iman in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those who pray salah, who give zakah, and fear none but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And inshaAllah, thumma inshaAllah, if we frequent the masjid, we hope to be in the register of these people in Yawm al-Qiyamah. The third, and inshaAllah, final topic I want to talk about from these various themes that Allah addresses has to do with the description of the munafiqun, the hypocrites. It's a very lengthy account, but I want to focus just on one part. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala towards the end of the 10th juz says, وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ عَاهَدَ اللَّهِ لَإِنْ آتَانَا مِنْ فَضْلِ لَنَصَّدَّقَنَّ وَلَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. That some people, they make a pact with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that financially I'm not in a good state right now. So ya Allah, enrich me. Allow me to get more wealth. Get me independence. And once I have that, definitely I will pay in charity. Definitely I will come to the masjid. When my financial stress is gone, ya Allah, you can count me among the righteous. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ عَاهَدَ اللَّهِ. They take a pact with Allah. They implore and beg Allah that, ya Allah, make my livelihood better, and inshallah you will see that I will give in charity. فَلَمَّا آتَاهُمْ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ بَخِلُوا بِهِ وَتَوَلَّوا. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses them with wealth, blesses them with better livelihood, now they become stingy, now they turn away, now they forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now that's the lesson that we need to learn. That whenever we have a need with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we make a pact with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we must ensure that we go through with it. Otherwise we'll fall under the description of those who make a pact, but when it comes time to walk the walk, there's no showing up. And this is very, very important. That خَيْرُ الْأَعْمَالِ أَدْوَمُهَا وَإِنْ قَلَّ. The best of actions are those that are done continuously, even if they're little. So whenever we have, perhaps, a difficult time in our family, we're going paycheck to paycheck, we're living by ends means. Yes, alhamdulillah, I have a roof on top of me. I have family around me. I have food for the day. What does Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say for such an individual? فَكَأَنَّمَا حُيِّزَتْ لَهُ الدُّنْيَا بِحَذَافِيرِهَا. فَكَأَنَّمَا حُيِّزَتْ لَهُ الدُّنْيَا بِحَذَافِيرِهَا. That if I have a roof, if I have food for just that one day, and I wake up and I can see my mom and dad, I can see my wife, I can see my family, I can see my children, I have my family around me, it is as though I have amassed the entire world. Think about the description. Think about the bar that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam sets for you and I. It's not that if I have a palatial home, it's not that if I have an excess in my bank balance to support me, my family, for the rest of the year. No. Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam is telling me that if you have a roof, food for the day, you have your family around you, you're the king of the kings. You have what many people in this world do not have. So we should learn to worship Allah, we should learn to be charitable within our means, even if it does not mean to be among the wealthy. And when we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among the wealthy, and we make it conditional that we will be among the pious if you do give and grant us that, we should be definitely willing to go through with that. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us with the message of the Quran. The first message that we learn is very clear. We must not dispute with one another on arbitrary ground. that I'm from a particular place, you're not from a particular place, my skin tone is such, your skin tone is such, my language is such, your language is such. We're Muslims. We don't allow that to divide us. Whether it's expressed clearly or whether it's subtly. A lot of times we may not say it clearly, but suddenly we act as such. Oh, that person, he's such and such. I can't deal with him, such and such. So Allah protect us from that. Da'wah al-jahiliyyah. Number two, we learn that those who populate the masjid are those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we should frequent the masjid and make our families among those who populate the masjid as well. And last but not least, when we make a pact with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we should definitely come through with it. And regardless of our financial means, inshallah, we keep our connection with Allah and the masjid to the best of our abilities. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enrich our lives with the Qur'an. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to benefit from the Qur'an in this life and in the hereafter. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi, subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik, nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Jazakumullahu khayran, wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.